If you look at when the Prime Minister announced the 20 lakh crore package, our markets went up. That was a direction opposite to what was the global direction. And the market was waiting patiently over the last few days to hear out the entire package. There is definitely some disappointment on the markets, in the investor sentiments. After hearing the entire 20 lakh crore package, the government says it's 20.9 lakh crore, while our estimates suggest that the actual spending from the government would be much lower compared to what the government announced. So what essentially the government has done is taken care of the supply side by the various measures that they are doing, rather than letting demand on their own. Now, the demand is something that will drive the supply over a longer period of time, and that is clearly not visible in the immediate future. And hence, I think the market reacted negatively. The people who were patiently waiting, they started withdrawing, including the FIIs, which have been seeing a sharp outflows. Even yesterday, we saw more than 2,000 from FIIs. So yes, definitely one of the biggest factors was the disappointment from the government package. It's an interesting stock. A lot of market following is there among the stocks. Results will be keenly monitored. While on the operational front, the March quarter was not that impacted. Only last 10 days of the quarter was impacted. So to that extent, the AUM growth of about 27% was healthy. On back of that, we are expecting a net interest income of about 35% and operating profit growth of about again 37-38%. What will impact is the higher provisions and credit cost slippages in the quarter, and that could lead to a much lower profit growth of about just 10-11%. Going forward for the current quarter, things look even worse, where the business has come to a halt and they will be reporting much weaker numbers. So the management commentary around how things look, the slower growth compared to what the street was expecting for Bajaj Finance over a longer period of time. Yeah, Nikunj, you rightly highlighted, compared to some of the larger peers in the banking space, for example, ICICI, where about 25% valuation is coming from subsidiaries. The valuation of subsidiaries in SBI has gone up to about 40-45%, largely because the market is not giving value to the core banking business. The concerns are that a lot of these credits that the government has promised in the packages may flow through some of these PSU companies, where the asset quality may not be that good, and it is much higher, given that this could be a lot of people who are in distress and may not be able to repay. So that is the concern that is impacting SBI right now, I would believe. So we have already seen the numbers for some of the heavyweights like ABB, Siemens coming out, and they have disappointed even in the March quarter. Going forward, it doesn't look like that the CapEx cycle is going to revive anywhere in the near future. Even before the pre-COVID era, we were seeing that the private CapEx cycle not picking up for the last few years. And now with capacity utilization much lower, we are witnessing a slower ramp-up with the lockdowns being gradually lifted, we don't expect a pickup in the CapEx cycle in the near term. So looking at that, the numbers would definitely be under pressure. So there are two parts of the capital goods. One is the order book inflows, which has already taken a beating. We had seen some improvement in execution over the last few quarters, but that is now also taken a beating, and that will lead to lower or subdued numbers from some of these capital goods companies, at least for the next 2-3 quarters. So overall, expect subdued performance from capital goods, at least for the next 2-3.